I'm going to teach 2.1, which is solving system of equations by substitution. My learning target is students will be able to solve systems of equations using the substitution method. So first things first, I put up these two systems of equations to be able to explain the basic process of substitution. So first things first, I have y equals 2x plus 1 and y equals 3x minus 6. Having these two, you're going to want to get a variable by itself. But these two already have that variable by itself, which is the y. Because of the variable being by itself, we can see that this is actually what y equals. So we can actually set these two just equal to each other because they both equal y. So to do that, it would be 2x plus 1 equals 3x minus 6. So then you're going to solve for your x value just using basic algebra. So you can subtract the 2x over and add the 6, which gives you 7 equals x. So now that you have your x, you can now solve for your y. To solve for your y, you can use any of the equations that have both variables in it. So in this case, you can use either of these two. I'm going to use the top one. So I have y equals 2x plus 1, and then you're going to substitute the x in this one with the x that you just found. So you have y equals 2 times 7 for your x plus 1. Then just basic math, you can see that y equals 14 plus 1 and y equals 15. So now that you have your two variables solved for, you want to write it in this notation where you have your x and then you have your y. So that's your answer for your first one. Then for a second walkthrough, I have 4x plus 7y equals 5, and I have x plus 3y equals 10. So like I said before, you want a variable to be by its side so that you can, by itself, so that you can solve for the other variable. So in this case, you're going to have to do some manipulating of these equations to get a variable by itself. So for this one, I would choose to manipulate this equation, which then you can pull this 3y over so that your x is by itself. So that gives you x equals negative 3y plus 10. So now that you have x by itself, you can plug it into the other equation. So you get 4, and then for your x, you have this, so negative 3y plus 10 plus 7y equals 5. So now you can solve for your y because you have it. So you're first going to distribute the 4, which gives you negative 12y plus 40 plus your 7y, because it's still on this side, equals 5. So now you can combine your like terms, which gives you your negative 5y plus 40 equals 5. And then using algebra, we know that we want our variable by itself. So we have negative 5y equals, and that you can find is negative 35. Then dividing by negative 5, we get that y equals 7 again. So then you can once again choose any of the equations that have both variables. And since these two equations are actually equal to each other, you can use either one of them. So I chose to use this equation. And so you have x equals negative 3. We know that y is 7. And then plus 10. So we have x is equal to negative 21 plus 10, which that means x is equal to negative 11. So once again, you want to write it in that form for your answer. So negative 11 and 7. In this form, it goes x, y, just so you know. So that's the second example. For my third example, I'm going to use a more complicated example. So I have 15x be 6. And then I have 6x plus 12y equals 18. So once again, you want to get one of your variables by itself, and so that you can solve for, or to be able to plug it into the other variable. So in this case, I am going to get x by itself. So to do that, first things first, I'm going to subtract my 12y over. So I have 6x equals, negative 12y plus 18. Then to get my x by itself, I have to divide by 6. So I get x is equal to negative 2y plus 3. So now that I have this, I can plug it into my other equation. So I have 15, and then we know that x is the negative 2y plus 3 plus 10y equals 46. So now that I have that, I can solve for y. And by distributing this 15, we get negative 30y plus 45. And then you bring this down, so you have your plus 10y equals 46. Then you can combine like terms, so you get negative 20y plus 45 equals 46. Then you can subtract this over to get your y by itself, so you have negative 20y equals 1. Then when you divide by your negative 20 to get y by itself, you get y is equal to 1 over negative 20. Then you solve for your x. I chose to plug it into this equation because this equation is just a manipulation of this one, so they're equal to each other. So I did x is equal to negative 2. You know that this is your y, so you have 1 over negative 20, and then plus 3. Then you can do this math, so x is equal to this, which is 1 over 10 plus 3, and then you can put it into a mixed fraction, or you can put it into an improper fraction. It's up to you. I would prefer an improper fraction, so I have 31 over 10. And then once again, you write it with your x and y. So you have 31 over 10, and you have 1 over negative 20 as your answer. So next thing I'm going to do is, first I'm going to erase the board. Then I'm going to do a word problem. So the word problem is, you are buying hot dogs and hamburgers at a concession stand. Each hot dog costs $1.25, and each hamburger costs $2. You spend a total of $71.25, and you have a total of 45 hot dogs and hamburgers combined. How many of each did you buy? So the things that we know, I'm going to use D for my variable for hot dogs. So D is equal to hot dogs, and H is equal to hamburgers. First, you want to set your variables so that later on you don't get confused. So now that I know this, I know that for each hot dog, it costs $1.25. For each hamburger, it costs $2. Then I know in total, I spent $71.25. Then I know that when you combined how many hot dogs I had and how many hamburgers I had a total of 45 dogs and hamburgers. So now that I know this information, I can form equations to be able to solve for how many exactly I bought of each. So now I can form equations. So knowing the value of how many hot dogs, I know that it's $1.25 per hot dog. Then I know it's $2 per per hamburger. Then I know in total, this is what I spent. So that all equals $71.25. Then I know that I had 45 hot dogs and hamburgers together. So I had hot dogs and I had hamburgers, and I had 45 of those together. So now you can solve these systems of equations. So first things first, you have to isolate one of the variables so that you can plug it into the other equation. So I decided to isolate h. So you get h is equal to negative d plus 45. Then you can plug that in to this equation. So you get 125 d is, or plus, $2, and then your h, which is negative d plus 45, equals 71.25. Then you will distribute the two in. So you have 125d minus 2d plus 90 equals 71.25. Then you combine like terms and you get negative 0.75d. And then by subtracting this 90 over, you get negative 1875. Then to get your variable by itself to solve for it, you divide by your negative 0.75 and you get that you had 25 hot dogs. Then, using whichever one you would like, using any of the equations that you would like, you solve for your hamburgers. So I'm going to use this same equation. So I have 125, you know that D is 25, plus 2H equals 71.25. So then you're going to see that this equals 31.25 plus your two times your hamburgers, equals 71.25. You can subtract the 31.25 over and you get 2h equals 40. Then by dividing by 2, you see that you had 20 hamburgers. So in total, you had 25 hot dogs, 20 hamburgers. Hope this all made sense. Thanks.